No. Shit. Wait until Vic sees you. Kidding me. Fuck! Okay. Alright, can you see me? Is the... Yeah, I think the exposure's fine. Okay, so... I feel like this is going to be a lot easier to explain to you if I just do it visually than just telling you word for word at the house, because more than likely you won't believe everything I'm going to say, so let me just show you. So how do you even start off? Last night I made a certain discovery. Surprising one, and I'll show you after I show you this video. But so after making this discovery, I decided to celebrate here. Well, me and Mr. Rummy Dum Dum here decided to celebrate together, actually. And so, well, I think you can kind of piece it together what happened. I got carried away last night, and the winds picked up, and I couldn't control it. I lost my oar in the river, which is just fucking lovely. And then, to top it all off, oh, wait, hold on. I got a pretty nasty hole scraped into the canoe and also scraped into me. I don't know, last night I must have caught my foot on one of those rocks over there. So yeah, I got a pretty bad gash hidden underneath right around here. And so I know for a fact that there is no way in hell that I'm making this journey on foot back home. So, well, at least not today. So my plan is right now just to sort of kind of let it rest, let it heal a little bit, make sure the bleeding's done, and then tomorrow I'm hoping that I can make my way back home. That's the plan. So, well, obviously, if you're watching this video, I made it back. So I just want you to know that I love you very, very much. All right, I'm not just doing this to smooth talk you over. I love you. And we're going to have a great night. We can go do something, whatever you want, whatever. Say it and we can go do it, okay, for you, just to make up for, well, this whole mess. So I'll probably just be camping out here for the night. I got the canoe all set up, like kind of like lean-to style in a way. And everything should be fine. And I'll see you soon, okay? And I love you. And we're going to have a great night.
Thank you. Wait, Scott. Scott, I could pay up. No bullshit, man. I know I've wasted a lot of your time. I know. But just think about it. Would you rather leave here empty-handed?
Adam, don't fuck with me. You don't have the money.
That's what I'm trying to say. I do have it. I shit you not.
Adam, I'm not falling for this bullshit. I've been getting talked out of this for too long.
It's my emergency fund. I don't know, maybe my house burns down or something. I told myself I'd never use it unless it was absolutely necessary. I'd say now is pretty damn necessary.
So, you're telling me that you've got an emergency fund that'll add up perfectly to the amount you owe me?
Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. If anything, there's probably a little extra. I'm willing to give it all up. You know, interest.
So, if I let this slide, then you'll bring the money to my doorstep by sundown. And if you even think about running away or involving the cops, then you won't be the only one suffering.
Deal.
Holy shit, you're finally back.
Yeah, let's just say things got a little carried away last night. But, hey, I'm glad I didn't try driving home drunk again.
I'm glad too, because it would have been me coming to save your drunk ass.
Oh, hold on. Keep in mind, I've had to do the same for you before.
When have I ever ended up in a ditch?
Fuck off.
What?
Don't give me that shit. Just because you weren't the one behind the wheel doesn't make the scenario any different.
You're talking about last summer, aren't you?
You and, Diana?
It's Donna.
Diana, same thing. Point is, you made it my problem because you were too chicken shit to call anybody else.
What was I gonna do, call Dad at 3 in the morning and get him to come tow us out of the ditch?
Look, all I'm saying is next time I'm in a pickle, you owe me.
Sure, whatever.
What, you reading another one of them gypsy articles or something?
Gypsy article? But why would I? No, it's the trail cam footage Dad told us to look over when he's at work.
I never called and told me that.
Well, maybe if you're here more often, you'd be here when you told me in person.
Whoa, wait, what the hell is that?
Well, that's what I've been trying to figure out. This guy's got his canoe all cockeyed.
Well, looks to me like he set up some sort of broke-ass lean-to. Why is he set up next to Dad's bait spot?
Nice view, maybe. It is right by the water.
Yeah. Is that... Wait a sec. Is he a fucking gold?
Well, that's what I was thinking, too. I mean, so good for him. Oh, shit. I gotta take this, but, call Dad. Remember this thing?
we stand on the rocky shore. But out there, beyond the horizon, there's more. There's more. We could only see a little of God's loving, a few rich treasures from his mighty store. But out there, beyond the horizon, there's more. There's more.
Hello?
Hey.
Hi.
Did you forget?
Forget about what?
Down here.
Oh, shit. Okay, yeah, I'll go ask Adam if he can give me a ride.
Okay.
Okay, see ya.
Make my way back home. That's the plan. So, well, obviously, if you're watching this video, I made it back. So, I just want you to know that.
Sorry to interrupt, but could you give me a ride to town?
Yeah, for sure. Just give me a minute, okay?
Did you ever mention to Dad about the whole trail cam thing?
I haven't gotten around to it yet, but I mean, what's the point? Look at the time. The guy probably left hours ago.
I mean, I guess so. But meet you outside?
Yeah, sounds good.
Know that I love you very, very much. All right, I'm not just doing this to smooth talk you over. I love you. And we're gonna have a great night. We can go do something, whatever you want, whatever. Say it and we can go do it, okay? For you, just to make up for, well, this whole mess. So I'll probably just be camping out here for the night. I got the canoe all set up, like kind of like lean-to style in a way. And everything should be fine. And I'll see you soon, okay? And I love you. And we're gonna have a great night. Okay.